فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
It's the last letter. Why do you concern yourself with the noon? The noon should not be your observing point aslan. You always need to look at the ending of the letter. So if I say to you, for example, the word yadhabanna, what is it that you need to concern yourself with? Yadhabanna. What is it that you need to look at? What letter do you need to look at? The ba. We're i'rab, we're looking at the last letter. So what's the sign of the last letter? Are we all together? It's mabni, but the alama is a fatha. If the alama is a fatha, this is nun with tawkid. Are we all together? This is what? Nun with tawkid. The reason why I'm saying to you, don't concern yourself with that, is if you look at it, the nun, and say it's a shadda or not, then you're going to come to, what about the khafifa? Nun tawkid is two types. There's a thaqila, there's a khafifa. Are we all together? So you don't look at the noon. You don't look at the noon. Whereas noon niswa, the ba is what? It's yadhabna. What's on the ba now? It's sukun. That's why the noon tawkid is mabni al fath, right? Whether it be thaqila or khafifa, it's mabni al fath. And if it's noon niswa, it's mabni ala sukun. That's what you observe. Don't concern yourself with the noon itself. Are we all together? That's very important that you do that. Are we all on the same page on that? Let's go to the waw now. We're going to move on to the waw, and then we're going to go to the alif, and then we're going to go to the noon, inshallah ta'ala. Which one does the author bring? So waw, وأما الواو أسفل the waw فتكون علامة للرفع في موضعين. The waw is مرفوع. Only the eight that we mentioned that we do إعراب of, only two of them are مرفوع بالواو. Are we all together, sisters and brothers? It's مرفوع بالواو, and the two are في جمع المذكر السالم. جمع المذكر السالم, what did we say it was? هو لفظ دل على أكثر من اثنين بزيادة في آخره صالح للتجرد وعطف مثله عليه, صح؟ That's what جمع ذكر السالم is. We explain what that meant. Are we all together? Let's take the example of the Quran that the شارح محمد محيدين عبد الحميد brought. فرح المخلفون. فرح المخلفون. أيه؟ فرح is what? فرح is a فعل ماضي. It's a past tense verb. المخلفون is what? What is المخلفون? It's the فاعل of what? فرح is فاعل. This is the subject of فرح. Are we all together? مرفوع. Straight away we have to say, if it's فاعل, it has to be مرفوع in every context. Are we all together? So it is فاعل, it's a subject. It is also what? مرفوع. Automatically you need to say that. But what is it مرفوع with this time? We ask ourselves, المخلفون is what? What is المخلفون? So you say فَرِحَ 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 الْمُخَلَّفُونَ. We said فَرِحَ is what? فِعْل مَاضِي. الْمُخَلَّفُونَ is what? It is فَاعِل, right? So you say فَاعِل. فَاعِل with مَرْفُوع with what? So it's فَاعِل. And it's also مَرْفُوع. Any fa'il, automatically, what do we have to say? We always have to say straight to marfu'. فاعل مرفوع. The question here is المخلفون. What do we need to look for? What is it? Which of these eight is it? Now, which one is of it? Is it المخلفون first? Remember, we have to identify first. Is it اسم مفرد? Is it جمع تكسير? Is it جمع أنث سالم? Is it فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء? Is it مثنى? Is it جمع المذكر السالم? Ha. Because جمع ذكر سالم, how does it express its the رفع? How does it show? It shows it on the واو. So here, where is the ضمة on? Sorry, where is the رفع on المخلفون? It's in that واو. Side that واو. Are we all together? That's how جمع مذكر السالم expresses and shows its رفع. Does that make sense? Are we all together? So that's why you say المخلفون. Are you with me? The word مخلفين, what is that? مخلفين جمع ذكر سالم as well. صحيح? But what's the difference between مخلفين and مخلفون? Huh? The difference between the two is that you can't bring it as مخلفين here. Because مخلفين is when it is منصوب or when it is مجرور. And here you're at a place which is مرفوع. Does that make sense? So if a person is praying behind you, doesn't study, he doesn't know the Quran, but he knows the Arabic language, and he heard you say فريح المخلفين بمك, he'll say to you, أخي, you're wrong. I have not memorized the Quran. Are we all together? I haven't reached Surah At-Tawbah, but one thing I can tell you is that is incorrect and the ayah can't be that. Why? Because it's a fa'il, and the fa'il is marfu' and the jam'u dhakr al-salim has to show with a waw. Does that make sense? Are we all together? So you have to say farihal mukhallafuna. And that's why once you do study grammar properly and you learn it properly, you'll be able to do tashkil on your own notes and your own books. You don't need to find a book that has tashkil on it, because you grammatically know what context it's in and what the sign should be. And then you have studied sarf, so you know that fariha came in the wazn of what? Fa'ila. And anything that comes in the fa'ila form, when it converts to a fi'il mudari', how does it look? You know all of that. Does that make sense? Very good. Then the second thing that's also marfu'un with waw is asma'ul khamsa. Just change the word fariha al-mukhallafuna. So the Sheikh brings a lot of example. لكن الراسخون في العلم منهم والمؤمنون ولو كره المجرمون إن يكن منكم عشرون صابرون. عشرون عمران is what's the Arab for it? It's a ملحق, صح? حمزة, what's a ملحق? يا عبد الأحد, what's a ملحق? سعد, what's a ملحق? إمران, what's a ملحق? Say that again. Say that slowly. Explain it properly.
So its meaning is jama.
Its meaning
is a plural.
Its meaning is a plural. Okay.
It doesn't have a mufrad in the meaning.
So it never comes as a mufrad now. So it's a jama that's only found as a jama. Ishrun cannot be made into a singular. If you try to make it into a singular, it becomes another word. Make sense? It's anything that you can't make into a singular. Make sense? It has no singular. It was found like this. The word is like this. Are we all together? Ashuruna is 20. If you say ashara, it becomes 10. It's not 20 anymore. So you won't find this word as a what? As a singular form. It's no singular. It only comes. This is mulhaq. Are we all together? It takes the ruling of what? Of the jam'u dhakr al-salim. and it's dealt with like a jam' dhakr salim. We'll take more of that inshallah ta'ala. So if we look at the ayah, لكن الراسخون في العلم منهم والمؤمنون ولو كره المجرمون إن يكن منكم عشرون صابرون. If we look at وآخرون اعترفوا بذنوبهم وآخرون اعترفوا وآخرون. All of those words. Look what Muhammad Hudin Abdul Hamid says. He says, فَكُلٌّ مِنَ الْمُخَلَّفُونَ وَالرَّاسِقُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُجْرِمُونَ وَصَابِرُونَ وَآخَرُونَ جَمْعُ ذَكْرِ السَّالِمِ. All of them are جَمْعُ ذَكْرِ السَّالِمِ. And they are دَالٌ عَلَىٰ أَكْثَرَ مِنِ اثْنَيْنِ وَفِيهِ زِيَادَةٌ فِي آخِرِهِ وَهُوَ الْوَاوُ وَالنُّونُ. All of them, they have shown more than two. They've shown more than two. And don't you see at the end it finishes with a waw and a what? A noon. Very good. And it's marfu' with what? All of them are marfu' with? All of them are marfu' bil wawi. Now you have to explain yourself, Lakin. Are we all together, brothers and sisters? Somebody has the rights to say to you, no one's got the rights to ask you if it's marfu' bil dhamma, because that's the asl. Remember, it's alamat asliya, right? But anything that's alama far'iyya, I have the rights to say to you, akhi, why is it marfu'un bil waw? Why was it not? Because the asl was meant to be dhamma. What happened here? You need to tell you, give your reason. What's the reason? The reason is because لأنه جمع ذكر السالم. So every time you say مرفوع فرح المخلفون فرح فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح لا محل له من الإعرابي المخلفون, you say فاعل فرح مرفوع وعلامة رفعه الواو نيابة عن الضمة لأنه. You have to explain it. لأنه, reason is because لأنه جمع مذكر سالم. Because it's جمع مذكر سالم. You need to explain yourself. But you never need to say لأنه اسم مفرد. You don't ever have to say لأنه فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء. You never need to say لأنه جمع تكسير. You never need to say لأنه جمع مذكر سالم. You never need to say that. Because those are upon the what? They are upon the asal. And you never ask about something that left its the asal. If you see a fi'il mudari' which is mibni, you ask why is it mibni or is it not? Fi'il mudari'. Yeah? Yeah, you ask. Because the asal of the fi'il mudari' is what? That only two halat that it becomes what? Mabni, right? So the person has the rights to say to you, lima buniya. Why is the fi'il mudari' mabni now? It shouldn't have been mabni. It should be i'rab. It should be under this chapter. Because you say, nunu tawkid or nunu niswa connected to it. Are we all together? So always remember that. And this is, it helps you even in usul al-fiqh. It helps you in other chapters, which is al-istishab, biqa' ma kana ala ma kan. What's the default position of everything? If you always try to do that in anything you're studying, if you always try to learn what's the asal, okay? What is the default position in this asal? If you're upon the asal, no one's got a right to ask you a question. Sah. Every individual is innocent until proven guilty. You don't have to go out there and prove your innocence. No, you don't. That's the asal that you're innocent. Anyone who now wants to remove that asal from you and to say that you're guilty, you're a criminal, wrongdoer, you're this, you're that, they now have to go out of their way and bring what? Evidences. You are here just going to say what? Prove it. Sah? Al-bayyinatu ala al-mudda'i. The evidences is required from the one who claims. So this is something that you need to generally learn and memorize. Okay? So here we say is that anything that is marfu alama far'iyya. So alama far'iyya, meaning it might be alif or waw or a noon, they have rights to ask you why. Why is it marfu'un bil wawi? Why is it marfu'un bil alifi? Why is it marfu'un bil nooni? Sah? They have the rights to ask you. You need to be ready because you need to know these ones that come out of it. Okay. The next one, which is marfu'un bil wawi, is what? Al asma'ul khamsa. It's on the board for you. Al asma'ul khamsa. For example, you say, أَبُوكَ رَجُلٌ صَالِحٌ أَبُوكَ رَجُلٌ صَالِحٌ. Your father is what? He is a righteous man. أبوك, your father is رجل صالح. He's a righteous. Let's just go according to how we were going. Let's always, فاعل is what we know. We don't know مبتدأ right now. صح؟ We just know فاعل for now. Let's just use فاعل, inshallah ta'ala, for everything. Are we all together? حضر. حضر. أبوك. حضر أبوك. صح؟ حضر أبوك. Your father came. حضر is what, حمزة؟ فعل ماضي. فعل ماضي. أبوك is what? فاعل of حضر. فاعل حضر. Straight away you need to say what is? مرفوع. Now you stop at this point. Now you stop, you say, you say أبوك is فاعل حضر مرفوع. Then you ask yourself, okay, let's look at the eight that was mentioned on the board. Which of these is أبوك? Is it اسم مفرد? No. جمع التكسير? No. جمع عن السالم? No. Is it فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء? No. Is it مثنى? No. Is it جمع ذكر السالم? No. Is it أسماء الخمسة? Yes. Now I look at where does أسماء الخمسة. So it's مرفوع with what? It's مرفوع with what? It's مرفوع with واو. So you say مرفوع بالواو. Again, because it's not upon the أصل and it's not علامة أصلية, what does the person have the rights to say to you? Huh? They have the rights to ask you why is it مرفوع with واو. What do you say? لأنه لأنه اسم من أسماء الخمسة. Because it's a name from the names of الأسماء الخمسة. Right? Are we all together? So because people are going to ask you generally, you just have to put it into your grammatical analysis when you're saying it. So this is how you say it. You say حضر فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح لام حلا من الإعراب. أبوك فإس what is it? فاعل حضر مرفوع بالواو نيابة عن الضمة. So نيابة is taking the place of the ضمة, right? نيابة عن الضمة. مرفوع بالواو نيابة عن الضمة لأنه اسم من أسماء الخمسة. Are we all together? لأنه اسم من أسماء الخمسة. Because it's a name from the names of أسماء الخمسة. You do it like that. You always need to say لأنه 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 if it's فرعية علامة فرعية. Very good. We're now going to move on to the ألف. The ألف is وأما الألف فتكون علامة للرفع في تثنية الأسماء خاصة. Are we all together? وأما الألف, as for the ألف, as for the what? As for the ألف, it is مرفوع. The only thing that's مرفوع بالألف is what? It's a what? It's a مثنى. مثنى means what? It's dual. It's when it's two, right? It's when it's what? When it's two. وأما الألف فتكون علامة للرفع في تثنية الأسماء خاصة. And this is specific to what? Specific to nouns only. Specific to what? Specific to nouns only. Can somebody give us an example, inshallah ta'ala? Somebody give us an example of a muthanna with the way we're going as a fa'il, inshallah ta'ala. Yeah? Yeah? Hadaras, hadara. Okay, good. حضر الصديقان. حضر is what? فعل ماضي. صديقان is what? فاعل حضر مرفوع with what? Before we go, فاعل صديقان. Again, we need to ask ourselves, which of these eight is it? Is it اسم مفرد? No. جمع التكسير? No. جمع عن السالم? No. فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء? No. Is it مثنى? Is مثنى. How do I know it's مثنى? Remember we said مثنى is what finishes with ألف and نون at the ending, right? Are we all together? So it's a مثنى. How does the مثنى express the رفع? It expresses itself with ألف. So you say مرفوع. You say مرفوع. It's مرفوع with ألف. إن شاء الله تعالى in the متممة الآجرومية we will take the شروط of the مثنى. شرط المثنى أن يكون معربا ومفردا منكرا ما ركب موافق في اللفظ والمعنى له مماثل له لم يغني عنه غيره. We'll take that إن شاء الله تعالى in what? The conditions of the مثنى we will take it إن شاء الله تعالى in the متممة الآجرومية بإذن الله الكريم. So don't stress yourself on that now. The noon is the last one left. We're left with the last one, which is the noon. And that is what we wrote here as أفعال الخمسة. And it's the last one for today, inshallah ta'ala. Who can help us with an example, inshallah ta'ala? For example, we can say as-siddiqani yusafirani, right? The two friends are traveling. Sah? As-siddiqani, the two friends are yusafirani. Yusafirani is what? It's fi'l mudari', hayya? Fi'l mudari', hayya? تعصل فعل مضارع is what you always need to know is مرفوع straight away. Why? Because you know the أدوات النصب or the أدوات الجزم before it. صح؟ يسافران is what فعل مضارع مرفوع وعلامة رفعه يسافران ثبوت النون لأنه أفعال الخمسة. Okay. Pay attention here. صديقان عمران وسعير ابو بيت مبتدا. اوكي يسافران is what so فعل مضارع هي what is it مرفوع. why are we saying فعل مضارع مرفوع because before it there's no ادوات الجزم or ادواته النصب. Do you have see أدوات الجزم والنصب before it? Do you see أدوات الجزم or النصب before it? No, we don't see أدوات الجزم. No, do we see أدواته? نصب. None of that we see. So then we said that the فعل المضارع, the أصل, the default position is what? أنه مرفوع. أنه مرفوع. That's the أصل. Now we want to say يسافراني is مرفوع with what? Okay, why? Is it اسم مفرد? No. Is it جمع تكسير? Is it جمع مؤنث سالم? No. Is it فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء? No, it's not فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء. Because there is something connected to the ending. Because if it was يسافر, لم يتصل بآخره شيء, صح. Nothing connected to the ending of it. But then يسافراني, ألف النون connected to the end. So نعم, it's not what? It's not فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. Okay, المثنى. Is it مثنى? هي عبد الأحد وايزن أو مثنى? Because it does finish with ألف النون at the ending. جميل. Do you know why? هل أحمد, why is it? Why is يسافراني not مثنى? It finished with ألف النون at the ending. Because مثنى is an اسم. And يسافران is a فعل. Just because it shows two. Are you there? It's not enough. It has to be a noun that shows two. Are we all together? So يسافراني is what? يسافراني is what? It's not a مثنى. Does it meet the criteria of a مثنى? Is it جمع مذكر سالم? No, it's not. Is it أسماء الخمسة? No, it's not. We're only left with the last one, which is أفعال الخمسة. How is it أفعال الخمسة? Remember we said أفعال الخمسة is a فعل مضارع plus an ألف النون, ياء النون, and واو النون. صح? That's all it is, right? That's what an أفعال الخمسة is. Are we all together? So isn't this فعل مضارع plus ألف النون at the end? Are we all together? So it, what does the فعل أفعال الخمسة, what does it become مرفوع with? It becomes مرفوع with the نون. That's how it expresses it. That's how it what? That's how it expresses it and that's how it shows. So what do you now say? You say فعل مضارع مرفوع بثبوت النون. The presence and the establishment of this نون is the إعراب for it. Are we all together? Are we all together? Am I making sense? No. I am making sense, right? نعم. So inshallah ta'ala, I am going to inshallah ta'ala leave it at that point. Bi-ithnillah al-kareem. All the exercises are on the kitab, the Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid's sharah of Ajrumiyah. Tuhfatu Saniyah. There are examples. I would really urge you all to try to do those examples. If you don't understand anything, you could always ask me. I really, really advise you all to not take it lightly, because learning a lot of exercises, looking at a lot of exercises and coming back and asking is vital, it's important. This will help you be able to read your own book. Abdullah ibn Abbas was asked, how have you attained knowledge and how did you gain knowledge? And he said, bilisanin sa'ul. I gain knowledge with a tongue that asks many questions. I ask too many questions. If a person wants to learn, he would have to be one like that. I'll conclude there inshaAllah ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.